had no instruments that could compete with electric instruments. There were no such things as electric marimbas. And so I was able to get tremendous satisfaction from doing some recording with him. But the idea of traveling, of being a member of the band, was something that seemed completely out of reach for so many reasons, and not the least of which was that we didn't have the technology for it. And then one day, he said to me, you know, you could make your marimba electric. And he described to me about Barkus Berry and transducers, and I thought, well, this sounds just wonderful. And then when he said, what they do is they drill into each bar. As soon as he said drill, you know, you'd be drilling into my body, because I owned at that time one marimba, the one that I had had since I was 16 years old. And to drill into that, that was just not going to happen. But Frank was so clever. He said, I'll get my vibraphone done if you get your marimba done. And I thought, you know, if he's going to take a chance with his vibraphone, and I know he had had that for a very long time, I'll do it. And so we traveled. We were able to travel with those instruments. It was extraordinary. I'll never forget the day that we plugged it in for the first time. I'm technically very challenged. I don't know. I still don't understand really how it worked. And thank God he had he had a lot of people that were good at that stuff. But they got it ready, and Frank handed me a mallet and said, okay. And I just went like that, and it was deafeningly loud. And he looked positively gleeful. He looked almost maniacal. Like, you know, now I can rule the world. I've got all the percussion at my disposal, because Frank was a percussionist. Did you know that? He was a percussionist. And now finally he had mallets that could travel too. So it was an extraordinary thing. I've seen him happy on a number of occasions, but that day was special. That was, you know, almost like Dr. Frankenstein in the 1931 James Whale picture. You know, it's alive, it's alive. And it was. Many of the parts that Frank wrote for me just suited me perfectly. It's the music that I would have written for myself if I had had that talent. And Frank knew how to do that for me. I think he knew how to do that for really everybody. There's a piece that was inserted into the Apostrophe album as part of St. Alfonso's Pancake Breakfast. It's called Rollo Interior, and this was the lead sheet that I was given. And if you can see, the absolutely gorgeous manuscript. I mean, and this was Frank writing it down as fast as he could. One for each decade that I've been away from the music and the instrument.
It's something that I felt compelled to learn on guitar, just because it's so much a part of Frank's compositional style, the rhythms, the melody of it, the way it all comes together with a sense of humor. But it's graceful, and it's just difficult as all hell.